about this guy who was in love with a girl whose name started with a C and ended with a K, and it was crack.
When you think about the beginnings of hip-hop, it's growing out of this space with Black people and Latinx people where they're creating as a result of their environment, really as a direct response to the stuff that's happening.
I spent a lot of time in Spanish Harlem at my grandmother's house, so I could see drugs rampant. First there were none, and then they were there.
My cousin said she saw you with this lady named C. Well, I'm poor. My thoughts, I wonder who she could be.
Hip-hop has become this place to chronicle the hurt and the pain that those who were making the music experienced in their communities when they looked around and saw folks that they love struggling with addiction long before we understand addiction as a public health crisis.
For me to put the story in first person was profound at that time because no one else was talking about it. So the next thing you know, I'm walking the New York City streets delivering packages, and this guy comes out. He says, okay, let me set. Yo, yeah, it's MC, yo. He calls all the guys, and I'm just stuck there with a mail bag around me, and I'm like, what do you know about MC Light? And he pulls it out. It was like, here you are right here. So I was like, oh, shit, my cover is blown. Like, I can't be out here delivering packages.
In 1988, MC Light drops the phenomenal Light As I Rise, her solo album by any artist who happened to be a woman.
I don't know that I was thinking about it back then. I was just doing it. It wasn't until later somebody told me. It's like, you know, you're the first to deliver. I was like, oh, yeah, I was the first. That's right. Tell me some more. It's a certain amount of fearlessness to not be afraid to speak your truth.
So I was like, okay, if I'm gonna call myself a rapper, I have to know like what this was to know where I'm going, you know? Looking up everybody, like all Bahamadia, MC Light. MC Light was like, what?